Good morning, campers. I'm out here in the travel trailer today because I just got this delivered. You can't see the labels covering up the H on the hatch lift. This is a cylinder system that you can get from Hatch Lift. They make a couple of different things. One is for your basement storage doors on your Class A's and that kind of thing. But these are for your bed. This is the bed lift system from Hatch Lift. They come in about four different sizes. This is the small because my bed that I'm sitting on right here is a short queen with a less than 30 inch bottom foot of the bed kind of storage area. So the small is what I got specifically made for this application. So it comes with, of course, the instructions, which are fairly straightforward. Your two hatch lift cylinders or your bed lift cylinders, a bag of hardware, which are even color-coded. They've got gold and silver screws in here so you can very easily tell what's what, and some brackets, four different brackets to put the each end of the two cylinders on, and a couple of wood blocks because you would probably need this to attach the top part of the cylinder to the bottom part of your bed. So that's everything that's in the box as far as what you need to install this. Probably a Phillips head screwdriver would be handy, a pencil to mark your different locations, a drill. I've got a little cordless drill here, and I've also got a Phillips head screwdriver to go on the end of this to make life a little bit easier in addition to the manual one. And I've got some painter's tape around here somewhere because I always find when you're marking things like this, painter's tape, very handy. Grab a couple of quick strips and you can throw painter's tape down to mark where you need to put stuff. So let's get started. I found my painter's tape, but you also need a measuring tape or something there akin to. So here's the deal. This is my short queen with a little storage area on the end. And I'm about to get this ready to install. It's different size compartments. Mine is a 26 inch all the way to the foot of the bed. The compartment's 24. So I'm going to say 26 since it's going to be holding up the entire end of the bed. The 26 inch compartments measure back 16 inches to install the lower bracket on the inside top rail. So here we go. 16 inches is going to be right here. Mount the lower bracket. Position the lower bracket on the top rail base. So you got two different size brackets in here. You got a big kind of rectangular squarish one, and you've got a little pentagon looking thing. And these pentagon ones are the lower brackets that you're going to want to install down here. And it shows them being installed like this with this side down. So this is where your tape can come in handy. See if I can do this because my fingers are in the way.
So I've kind of hung these with some painter's tape just so I have a free hand and they don't float around on me while I'm marking the holes. Just a little tip for you. Over here I've got the heating duct comes in, so I still have enough room to do the bracket right there, no problem.
Alright, so the 5/8 inch screws in here are the silver ones, and we're just going to take a couple of these right now and attach those. They are standard wood screws, Phillips head, so they're, I don't think I really need to pre-drill. I'm not in danger of splitting the wood. And they should go in pretty straight. And okay, so I've got those just a few turns in. I don't want to tighten them down yet, because I might have to adjust something here in a little while. So, you work with what you got. it's hard to do this upside down, so I'm just going to climb in here and... Alright, so pre-drilling the holes, not an absolute must. Obviously, your mileage may vary. You may have a different setup, but I doubt it. These campers are not, you know, put together with hardened oak. It's pretty much all plywood, so no problems there getting the screws a little bit in. Alright, so I've got those mounted a little bit, just a little bit. So now I move on to, well, it says go ahead and attach the rod end to the bracket. So which is the rod end? Notice that these guys, very simple. This is the rod end, the thinner end, and then this is what they refer to as the cylinder end. So this is up. Your cylinder is going to be on the bed side. Your non-cylinder, your rod end, is going to go down onto your lower brackets. So these are really simple to get on. They just snap, basically snap right on. If I can get a decent shot of me putting this on here, it doesn't take a lot. I'm one-handing it, and it just snaps right into place. So. Okay, so we've got the rods on. No problem. Next step says temporarily attach the angled bracket to the center wood block. Okay, so here's where our wood blocks come in. The wood blocks come with this, and I am going to show you a cool trick. So here's the deal on wooden blocks. What we want to do is mount these little guys, and these are square, so it doesn't really matter which way we mount them. But what we want to do is pretty much center them on the block. So let me show you how you find the center of this block. It's really simple. Get a straight edge. You can use your not uber critical on this, but you can get your tape measure and just go from corner to corner and make a mark. And do the same on the other corner. Now, this is an old carpentry trick of finding the center of any kind of piece of wood, be it square, rectangular, it doesn't really matter. Alright, so I've drawn an X basically on my wood here from corner to corner, and that is the center of the block right there, that X. So now I can kind of put this in here. And it doesn't actually have a hole in the center, but, you know, hey, whatever. You can get it centered on there. And I suspect getting this perfectly centered is not really super critical. But if you want to find the center, that's the easy way to do it. Again, I'm going to grab my painter's tape. God, I love painter's tape. And we're just going to strap this guy down to the wooden block. And I'm just going to eyeball this other one. Again, I don't think it's super, super critical. As long as we kind of have it straight. And then we can be moved a little. We can get that tied down. And then we are going to do the I've got the instructions here. Unlike most men, I do tend to read the instructions sometimes. Temporarily attach the angled bracket to the center. So what we're going to do is just take a couple screws. And you can see they're almost self-tapping. It takes a little bit of pressure. You could pre-drill these if you wanted to. You could pre-drill the holes in here if you wanted to. But I'm just going to put a couple screws in each corner. There we go. Okay. So there we go, we've got our wooden blocks.
Attaching these temporarily. We don't want to put the screws all the way down tight, because we are going to have to probably adjust some things.
Alright, the next step, it says, is to take your little mounted pieces here and go ahead and attach. Well, here's the problem. Go ahead and attach the cylinder end and then rotate it into place. So what we want to do is get this up here in position that we think the final assembly is going to be with your ball in your cylinder pointing to the outside, of course, and then kind of get this where you think it's going to be. Now I'm going to get this mounted, I hope, about as vertically as I can. This is a pretty much vertical right here, and I want to line it up, of course, so that it clears it as straight as possible with the side of the bed. And I think I've got it right there. Okay, I have had absolutely no luck. I've had absolutely no luck getting this gas cylinder back off of this. So there's something later on in the instructions about prying off a spring clip or something, but it's really not meant for this part of the... I don't know if it's just bad instructions or what. What I'm going to do is switch over to a drill bit on my drill and get a couple of holes pre-drilled in here. At least one. Just to get my very first screw started. And maybe the other screws will go in without needing to drill a hole. Okay, here in the instructions, it's very nice. It says switch over to the gold screws. I love that they're color-coded that way, silver and gold. And that way you can be sure you're using the right screw to get these guys in place. Alright, that's the first screw for the first wood block here. Hopefully the other guys will go in. Tell you what, I'm going to go ahead and pre-drill these holes, because it does makes life a hell of a lot easier. So we're just going to go ahead and come in about a quarter inch on each side. Ah, okay. That last hole is a little crooked because the cylinder's in the way. Probably why the instructions do say remove it. But let's go ahead and try to get these screws in place. All right, well, that seems pretty solid on this side. Of course, I've got the other screws on the bracket still to tighten down. But I'm not going to do that until we get that adjusted properly. So this is pretty much rinse and repeat here on this side, but I've got to remove these wooden holders that I've got. And guess what? The one strut that I've got in place, it's doing the job. It is holding the bed up. And that's going to allow me to get this other one in place pretty easily, I do believe. So, let me go ahead and pre-drill the holes on this. And we connect our rod, just snaps right in. And then we try to get this as lined up as possible. We want to get this vertical, and we want to get the strut straight up and down as parallel to the edge of the bed as we can. And once we have that done, we can switch over to a drill bit. I mean a screwdriver bit. Alright, so we're pretty pretty parallel there, and we're pretty straight there. So this is where we want to put in our wood block. Now that we've pre-drilled our holes, we can get that first screw in with one hand. That's nice. Be able to get that in there like that. Now let's talk particulars. How much was it? Depends on the size that you need. This was the small size, and they're $49.99. Get them at hatchlift.com. I found them through another YouTube channel, and I'll give a quick shout out to the RV Geeks. RV Geeks on YouTube. They do a great job with all sorts of hints and tips and tricks for your trailers and your RVs, Class A's. The guy that owns the channel, he's got this awesome professional announcer voice, and it's just it's a lot of fun to watch and listen to him at RV Geeks on YouTube. He also, and I don't know how much longer that this lasts, and I know YouTube is forever, but I found hatchlift.com through RV Geeks on YouTube, and they had a special running with RV Geeks at Hatchlift where you could get 5% off. So I saved $5. I used the RV Geeks code to get 10% off my purchase of $49.95. So, I think with shipping and everything, this cost me about $60. They do FedEx shipping, so it's not too cheap, but it's not bad. I think it cost me about $60 right around, all said and done, out of pocket to get these little guys. And you know what? I think I am done. Alright, so what I have found is it's a little tight. Alright, so I'm a little tight here. I've got too much lift going on. I've also got another problem here at the bottom of this cylinder, is that this bracket needs to come up about half inch. It fell down a little bit when I tightened it in. But the most important thing is I need to decrease the tension. To do so, on this particular model, the small model, we move the bracket towards the head of the bed. And by doing so, we decrease the lift that's going on. So I'm going to take these brackets out and move them up about 2 inches, and that should give me less lift and a little bit more room for this cylinder to actually fold under. Alright, I don't know if you can see the original marks I had there at 16 inches, but I moved them back, the brackets back about 3 inches here. This is a 2 inch difference from the original 16, 2 inches, so I'm about 3 inches back on the center line. And I got this nice new strut system. It holds my bed down, or up, I should say. So that's it. Hatchlift. Whew, well, I'm a little out of breath. That's it. The Hatchlift system for bed lift. Hatchlift.com. About $50 for the small size. They make them all the way up to holding up a full size queen bed in a Class A kind of situation. But a pretty simple installation. Mine are still a little strong. I think the bed's going to come up when I get off of it. But that's okay. If it continues to be strong, I can always move the brackets again. That's very simple to do. I'm going to leave it in this position right now because these gas cylinders do tend to come from the factory really strong, and with a little bit of wear, they tend to get a little loose. So I think maybe where I've got them now is a good spot for you know, a few months in the future after they get used a little bit. Right now they're pretty tight, and pretty much the bed comes up by itself. But that's okay.
I can always adjust this by moving these bottom brackets towards the head of the bed an inch or two more and cut down on the lift factor.
So there you go, campers. The hatchlift.com bed lift system, about $50. Have I used it yet to recommend it or not? Obviously not. That's just the installation, but I will let you know in a future video how it's working out for me. In the meantime, you camp safe and keep chasing the odd little happy.